Morning. Today, in this session, we are going to teach about the Unit 1 IC engine. So, here is the IC engine. So, basically, according to the your syllabus, we have 3 units. So, in the 3 units, entire thing like a different parts of the IC engine. Second one is the efficiency, after that performance parameters be calculated. Parameters should be calculated. So what is the engine? So it is a heat engine, actually called. So after that, the heat engine is divided into 2 types. One is internal combustion engine, another one is external combustion engine. So if the fuel is burned inside the tank, closed container, then it is internal combustion engine. If the fuel is burned open atmosphere, then it is external combustion engine. Okay, so see here, an IC engine is a heat engine in which combustion of fuel occurs within a combustion chamber, means is under internal combustion engine. So fuel is burned inside the combustion chamber, so that it is internal combustion engine. So after that, this engine is classified into different types. So that depends upon nature of thermodynamic cycles. It's a Otto cycle, diesel cycle, and dual cycle. Okay? So if it is an Otto cycle, petrol is used. Diesel cycle, then the diesel is used. Dual cycle is for petrol and diesel engine. So types of fuel. The fuel may be petrol, diesel, kerosene, biofuels. Okay? And some of the gases, say the gases have been using in the nowadays in the automobile industry. Okay. So after that, number of strokes. There are 2 types of engines on the number of strokes. One is 2-stroke engine, another one is 4-stroke engine. Like with the 4 processes like combustion, expansion, exhaust and intake. The 4 processes that can be complete within one cycle, that is called 2-stroke engine. That is called top to bottom, bottom to top. Top dead center to bottom dead center, bottom dead center to top. So within one cycle, all the 4 processes will be completed. That is called 2-stroke engine. If it is a 4-stroke engine, then there are 2 cycles. 2 cycles required for completing the 4 process. Means every stroke is a different process. Intake, compression, expansion, exhaust. Like that. The 4 process will be done. Types of ignition. So spark ignition engines are there. And self-ignition, that is compression ignition. Inside the fuel combustion chamber, fuel can be burned 2. One, by reducing the flame by external resource. Second, reducing the fuel flame by itself, by compressing the fuel. The compressing what will happen? When the compression occurs, the heat energy will be increased. Heat energy will be increased. So pressure increases, heat energy increases. So that pressure and heat such that it can attain the ignition temperature of that fuel. So there are 2 types, spark ignition and self-ignition. Number of cylinders, single cylinder, multi-cylinder. Position of the cylinder may be horizontal, vertical or V-shaped. See, there are the components. So what are the main components of engine? Start to remember. Okay. So components, the engine head, engine, and the crank is, the engine head, the cylinder head or engine head is the place where different accessories can be fit. Different accessories like spark plug, cap, camshaft assembly, and any lubricant pipes will be there. Will the fitment. So in the cylinder head, so what is it? Inlet valve, exhaust valve, okay? Camshaft will be there, cam will be there, spark plug will be there. So these all small accessories are fitted on cylinder head. And remaining part is the combustion chamber where the piston is that reciprocates. Piston is like it reciprocates. This is the piston. Okay. After that, there is a connecting rod. Connecting rod. So connecting rod, the supports in the camshaft, so convert that reciprocating momentum into rotary momentum. So it will transfer the power from piston to connecting rod, connecting rod to the camshaft. So actually the camshaft, spark plug, cylinder head, intake valve, exhaust valve, and the combustion chamber, and the block of the cylinder, piston, crankcase, connecting rod, camshaft. These are the some of the parts of the engine. So if you take how it is working, how it works, you can see here. So then I told you already, if it is a four-stroke engine, the four different processes will be in place. Okay? So first we see the intake. Intake. In the intake, inlet valve will be opened. The intake, inlet valve will be opened, fuel is drawn, or fuel is sent to the combustion chamber. Fuel is sent to the combustion chamber, where what happens if you are adding the some quantity of mass there. So again the pressure is acting on the piston head, so we move from top dead center to bottom dead center. Dead center means the maximum piston can move upward direction, piston can move downward direction. So the top dead center, the bottom dead center. So that, so here top to bottom dead center. So this one. After that, here came here. Okay. Now again, if you use this one, but that now expansion happens. So in this process, intake process, the flywheel is the device which is the stores the energy, from itself, stores the energy itself, so that it will get compressed and burning will be takes, So that burning process is called power stroke. So at the power stroke, what will happen? The piston will be moved from top dead center to bottom dead center. Okay. So when it moves again back to the bottom, so there is a device already told, the flywheel. That flywheel is stored the energy, will get released. And exhaust gas will be used. Okay. Exhaust gas will be goes outside.